Alright, what is going on, my lovely people of the world? How y'all? Oh, good, I did get in here in time. I didn't think I got in here in time. I thought I was going to have to find a way to talk for all 3 out of 5 of these rounds that we there. DFA X Calamity is a PlayStation 3 player. That's what that shit means when it takes so goddamn long to load. PS4 version loads a lot faster. So, I am merely in Spectation mode. I did try to play a little bit before this just to see where I was at, just to see what I was capable of. And I wouldn't say I'm terrible, but I don't really understand my tools yet. I think that's the best way I could put it, is that number one, I don't really understand my tools, and number one, I don't utilize them. Some of the ones that I do at least understand, I don't really utilize them in a proper fashion. And I'm certainly not doing combos like this fucking Johnny player is doing. What the fuck, this character? That was half a life bar. That was half a life bar. Holy shit. Oh my good god. Yeah, once he chucks a few coins in your... Ooh, excuse me. Once he chucks a few coins in your face, he goes from a major problem to, oh please god, don't touch me. But yeah, so anyway, like for instance, one of the biggest things I've caught myself at being particularly bad at is maintaining awareness of my Jacko's little huts. I will lose them fairly often, and like, I'll see somebody hitting them and I'll recognize that and be like, okay, I should go in and stop that. And then I do, and I stop it, and I don't pay attention to the fact that sometimes I stop it right after they get the last hit that took the hut down, and thus that hut is no longer there, and that's kind of a problem. So that kind of thing. And I'm also, or just recognizing points in time in which I could actually put a hut down myself. Like I get a knockdown or something and I just kind of briefly am like, oh wait, shit, let me put down the kick one. Oh wait, the kick one's already down. It's the punch one that isn't down, or it's the slash one that isn't down. That kind of thing. So I need to be a lot more, I need to develop significantly more awareness in regard to my resources. That's the number one thing I need to work on. Then there's the obvious stuff that you gotta do every time you try and learn a new character, and that is hit confirms, combos in general. Because the problem is, I worked a lot on doing all of Jacko's trials, or her combo stuff, whatever. They're not actually called trials in this game. But oh my god, what's it called? Shit, what's that shit called? Is it just Perfect Guard? Whatever, that spam right there, that was a lot of it. But yeah, I spent my time, I've done everything except for the very last one, because the last one's really annoying. It's got, oh, you should just kept it there. Nobody ever guesses the original. That did no damage whatsoever for being a Hellfire. Actually, it's... Johnny's about to show you what real damage is. Welcome to Guilty Gear, motherfucker. Get used to this character. But yeah, so I did all of her trials except for the very last one, because the very last one has this... Oh, it's so awkward. It seems really simple. All of Jacko's trials look really simple initially. They don't look like they really have anything complicated to them. Ooh, what did I do? I spectated a certain amount of matches. Yep. So they all look really simple, and so her 10th trial requires you to do a forward throw into a Roman cancel. You lay down one of her huts, you dash underneath, do a 5S, first hit of 6HS, cancel that into another hut placement, and by that time the first hut has spawned a little dude that will continue the combo for you by hitting them. And so you place the hut, then you do an instant air dash into air slash, air. I think you just go straight from air slash into her, the 4D kind of. It's not actually a command grab, but it looks like a command grab. You go into that, then you spit it back down diagonally toward where you spawned the little huts. Again, they continue the combo for you, and then I think you do like a grounded, just a regular punch into another place, into the placement of the third and final one. And then you do something, I can't remember it from that point, because I have never managed to get the one from the punch hut to actually combo into it properly. They always hit it too early, which means I am placing the hut too early, or I am taking too long on like the instant air dash into jump S, that kind of thing. There's a multitude of factors that could be screwing up my timing there. Is everybody just watching these two players play? Is that what's going on? That's kind of funny. that explains why nobody hopped into play while I was on the other one. But yeah, so it's... I've never gotten that down, and so I was just kind of like, alright, fuck this. This isn't even an important combo to me. I mean, I guess it is. It could be an important combo, but it doesn't seem like it's really all that useful overall. But we'll see. I mean, I need to look at things, obviously, to determine what would be an ideal combo off of, for instance, getting the throw into having meter. But anyway, so then I started playing arcade mode. I did a very brief stint in MOM mode, and then I decided, nah, this isn't worth it. It's just better to just practice in versus, because eventually I'm going to be powering up my character, and then eventually I'm not going to be playing the same character. So I just sat in versus for a while, and I realized, thanks to advanced combo number 9, which is the one I spent a lot of time on, which begins with 2K, 5 slash, 5 heavy slash, and you just do that. I realized I kept autopiloting into that, and that's not good. That is not a good place to be, especially in a case where you can't cancel into the super that you're supposed to do afterwards in that trial to begin with. But if that super doesn't combo off of 5 HS in the middle of the screen anyway, which is generally where I'm getting these hits that cause me to go into that move. It's terrible for me to be doing that move. I need to stop doing that move. And so, like, that's one of the big things that I need to do, is kind of just rid myself of the muscle memory I've built up doing those trials, because they're honestly not very good. Like, there were combos, like, for instance, that advanced combo number 9. Initially, I was like, oh, this is a really cool combo. It allows me to place all 3 of the huts in one combo, and it also allows me to incorporate, it necessitates the spawning of the little minions and actually including them to continue the combo properly. That's really cool, in my opinion. And then I thought about it a little bit more, and it just occurred to me that, like, this is a corner-specific combo that requires you to not have a single minion spawned or a single hut placed. That will never happen if you're a Jacko player. That's just not gonna happen. So that kind of, that realization was like, oh, this combo actually isn't really all that useful. I don't need it. Okay, what about the other combos that I liked? One of them was, requires you to do a low air dash to the ground. You do air S, air HS. You land, you immediately go into 6 HS, and you cancel that into a super jump, into an instant air dash, air P, air S, air HS. That was really awesome, initially, to see that shit work. It was like, oh my god, this is really cool to be able to do something and then go into an instant air dash off of a grounded combo. Chip does that, too. And it's one of my favorite combos of his. And so, I'm sitting there like, oh cool, I really want to practice this combo, and then it occurred to me, this requires you to hit a point blank non-counter hit 6 heavy slash. That will not happen. Now, again, I shouldn't say it won't happen, because obviously everything is going to happen at some point in time. But it is not going to happen enough to the point where I should have I should have the muscle memory necessary to do this specific combo off of it every single time. It also necessitates that they will be standing. So the other way to begin it is to land a jumping attack into point blank 6 heavy slash. When are you going to land a jumping attack on somebody who is standing there? Like, that's not going to happen. They're going to be you're going to land it on a crouching opponent. It's just, it's the chances of it happening are basically impossible. And so that was a disappointment, and just went on from then. You know, I'm kind of sitting here like, all right, I need to actually learn real combos. So I need to go and do that. And one of the things that I'm working on the most is actually in the corner. I want to be incorporating 6P into my combos. 6P into the first hit of 6 heavy slash, into jump 2D, and then from there I do like a juggle of some sort. I need to figure out the optimal combo from that point. I'm thinking it might actually be 2 heavy slash, because that's another move that I'm not using in combos nearly as much as I should. I like this Kai color. So it looks like he has like a sort of lightsaber. Dig that. Kai is the character I should be using. He's just so easy. Not to say that Jacko is not also an easy to use character, but it's like, execution wise, they're pretty fucking similar in terms of like combo, overall combo difficulty. But Kai has a better neutral game and more damage. and he has a projectile. And he isn't basically reliant upon the snowball effect. I.e. with Jacko, if you manage to put down the huts and just maintain consistent pressure so the opponent cannot hit them, that's actually another thing I really need to work on, is just being able to automatically grab huts. I keep trying, and like I'm either just outside of range, or I keep accidentally holding like two instead of, two. No, I keep holding either one or three instead of just straight down and throw, it's 2P to pick up one of the huts. And if you are not aware of how that works, it's when you throw it at somebody, the amount of hit stun, block stun it puts you, both hit stun and block stun, is fantastic. It's probably the single best move Jacko has in her entire arsenal is to force you to block one of those because of the advantage it gives her. So working on that is another big thing, because I keep like running up and hitting like down back or down forward instead of just straight down, and then I wind up missing it. Or alternatively, I don't have the punch hut down yet, and I'm just mashing down plus P, and then I accidentally place the hut instead of grabbing one, because I'm a fucking idiot. One of the two. Yeah, both these players are pretty decent, pretty solid. Definitely not, like, amazing, because that Johnny player is relying far too much on that, like, whatever that dash into that upward kick is, and also just doing that same sword slash over and over and over again. Nice. Yeah, he wasn't respecting him. Actually, I don't think, has this Kai done a DP yet? Oh, let's go! Oh, nice block. Bad combo. Oh shit, he's gotta be able to follow. Well, he's definitely gonna follow that shit up. That happened. The only setup I have figured out for myself so far with Jacko that's mad dirty is basically doing something that fucks with your vision. And so, for instance, like her fireball super, and then dashing forward into six kick, which is, as far as I'm aware, it's an overhead. It sure as hell looks like an overhead. It might not be, for all I know. But she does a little hop, and then just kind of stomp. It does like a two-hit stomp. And if you cancel the first hit early enough, you can then do an instant air dash after that and land a jumping loop. Or alternatively, you can just go straight down and throw out a low. So that is the dirtiest setup I have found personally. So on the off chance they do actually block that overhead, I then have a 50-50 mix-up directly after it. And then the only time I managed to set up into it, motherfucker blocked the overhead, and then I meant to go from overhead into another overhead, and I canceled too late, and just went straight down to the ground, so I just got a default 5S afterward, which obviously is not a mix-up. And I was so sad, because not only did I have that fireball going off in their face, I had like five minions surrounding them, and I was like, man, this is going to be so sick, and then they blocked it, and I just got so sad. I'm starting to get there. And obviously, this is essentially a brand new fighting game to me. I would be surprised if I played more than 20 matches of Guilty Gear in my entire time with Sign. So this may as well be a brand new game to me. And obviously, being brand new to a fighting game, it's going to take a lot of effort to get to an even decent level, let alone a fantastic one. Oh, God. Johnny damage, no. Kai, no, you were doing so well. What does that mist shit do? I don't actually... Was that an unblockable? Because he was blocking that entire thing, and I can't imagine at that range he would try to press a button. Might have tried to jump. But knowing Johnny, that could very well have just been an unblockable, because they made Elfell. So... the possibility of situational unblockables is certainly not... They also made Kokonoe. Well, not the same team. Who knows, maybe Kokonoe's design came from the Guilty Gear team. They asked to put a character in Blaze Blue, and Kokonoe is what they came up with, and that's why she ended up being so fucking stupidly broken. Gotta use that, what's it called? Is it just called Perfect Guard? Perfect Block? When you utilize the meter to do it? I actually had no idea that you could hold it down. Like, all this time, I thought people who were doing, you know, like, a significant amount of them in the air to, or, like, blocking chip and stuff. Not actually the character chip, but blocking chip damage from multi-hit projectiles. We're just, like, mashing incredibly hard. And this entire time, you can just hold down, back, or back, plus the buttons, and I was not aware of that. I thought you had to mash it if you wanted to get multi-hit moves. So it's very good to know that you... But, like, that basically proves my ignorance toward the majority of this game in general, and why this is essentially learning a brand new game. And the world doesn't actually want me to. It keeps putting distractions in my face. I mean, beyond just the regular... life responsibilities in terms of video games. Obviously, I've mentioned Odin Sphere numerous times, but that's done and over. And I had a couple of free days dedicated to Guilty Gear. Just doing that. I didn't do anything else. I just played Guilty Gear. I did everybody's trials. I did a bunch of mission modes. I was making some I've at least made enough progress now to where if I see, like, button prompts, I know which button to press. And I'm not just, you know, pressing kick thinking that's punch all this time. That kind of thing. So I at least have that going for me. But then, Gamefly sent me Overwatch. And now I'm nowhere near as absorbed in it or want to play it as much as I was with Odin Sphere. But it is quite a bit of fun. And I do it. Jesus, that damage. Look at that red. Oh my god, why? So does that shit happen... So it looks like he levels up regardless of whether or not you block it. The coin. Yeah, see, he really likes that kick. Yeah, he really likes that kick. It's understandable why he gets fucking stupid damage off of it. It looks like the kind of move that probably has low invulnerability to it. And it's very obviously safe, given that he just keeps doing it, and they're very clearly in block stun the entire time. So there really isn't much of a reason to not just keep doing it. It's also too fast to react to. Like, maybe with Jacko I could do it, because Jacko's DP is just a single button. Her DP is just 2D, that's it. I don't have to do, like, an actual DP motion. But... actually having to do a full 6-2-3. Because the thing is, I'm pretty sure it'll come out even if I hold 3D. So that means if I do it late, I'm already in block stun and I'm blocking it and it's no big problem. And I can't really do it early because he moves forward so fast. That at the very... because it's a two-hit move, so at the very least the second hit will hit. Granted, it could result in a trade because the move doesn't have a ton of invincibility. It's unfortunate that nobody else wants to play. I was hoping that given how many people were standing here, it would result in more diverse matchups. But so far, almost every single time I've spectated, Johnny's been included in some fashion. And I always questioned the actual quality of Johnny, a little bit. Because everybody was talking about how amazing he was, how basically broken he was, best character in the game, so on and so forth. Jerry's still out on my end on just how good he is, because the only real Johnny that I've seen from Japan footage is Kirinchu. And I can't remember who that person played. I want to say Ramlethal, originally in Sign. But I remember the name from Sign. And I'm pretty sure there was a stint with Milia. I know there was a stint with Soul. And Kirinchu was good with every single one of them. Very good. A top level player with every single one of them. And so when you're looking at a player like that, who is playing at the highest level of competition and succeeding with any character they pick, you can't see them pop off with a character and be like, oh my god, that character is so fucking broken, this is ridiculous, they're too good. If somebody comes out of the woodwork, somebody that's been playing forever and just suddenly picked up a new character and suddenly they're winning tournaments, whereas before they were struggling to get top 8, that's the point when you kind of look and analyze the strength of that character. This Kai is going bonkers. Holy shit, Kai! Get in that asshole, and he didn't even die! Holy crap. And watch how much this... that single super did more damage than that entire combo. That makes me so sad. But yeah, there's been numerous... I'm not gonna name names, because people are gonna construe that as me calling out the quality of specific players, and I'm not gonna do that. But there are many people who, like, they stick with a single character, for instance. They're the kind of people that main a very specific character, and all of a sudden, they win, you know, like a patch happens, that character gets better, and suddenly they win a tournament. And suddenly everybody goes, oh shit, he's finally hit his stride. Or she. I'm not gonna be sexist. He or she finally done hit their stride. They're becoming a good player. And then another patch happens, which kind of brings them back to the character back to the quality they were beforehand. And then they stop winning. And they're no longer doing as well. And they wonder. Huh. Wonder what happened. Well, the game got patched. That's what happened. There's a variety of qualities of player. There are the players that are strong enough that they can win tournaments with just about any character possible. They're the type of people who are very good, but they just haven't quite reached that upper level yet, and so if they pick the right character, they can start knocking down that door due to the strengths of that character. I really just watching this really does make me question, like, why am I just not playing Kai? He's just so good. How much time has it been? 23 minutes almost? Because I don't want to keep watching this one dude over and over. Oh shit, we can pop in right here. Oh, is everybody spectating? What are we at, my dude? I can't tell what connection quality. 2-bar? Fuck it, let's do it. I'm a fucking scrub. But y'all gonna see one match of my scrub. Oh, is this dude just sitting? Nope, okay, we good. Fuck. It's gotta be a Johnny. Please don't be a real Johnny. Damn, both of them left too. Those people that I was spectating, they both left at the same exact time. Yes, Johnny, we get it. You were designed to be edgy. Yes, Jacko, we get it. You were designed to have a booty. Oh, cool. That was supposed to be an instant air dash, and I failed. No! That was supposed to be an air dash, and it very obviously wasn't. Oops! That was not what I wanted that to be. Oh, that was not okay. I thought because it was a counter that he would. Jesus, why does this keep happening? Just keep mashing that jab, dude. Like, once I understood that was happening, that became mad simple. Oops, shit, I need to stop doing that. I do that a lot, accidentally get 2HS, and that's just not a good move. I didn't get my placement. Shit. Fuck, please die. God damn it. That combo? I didn't know that combo. Oh shit, I just learned something. Thank you, Johnny, for teaching me something new. I'm gonna. Oh, fuck. Fuck. I have no idea. I did not know what that was. I had no idea what that was. Fuck! Why did my shit not come out? Don't you fucking dare! Oh, goddammit. Oh, really? I don't know what that miss did. I don't know what the miss does. Oh, really? That doesn't combo? Okay. That doesn't combo. Noted. And split shield. Oh, damn, I thought he was airborne. Nice burst. I did not know. Okay. Jesus Christ. Do you see why I am not in match-ready conditions? I keep missing things. Because there's a lot of, like, awkward delays between things. I think, how do I do that myself? How do I... Well, he's gonna leave before. Okay, let me. I guess I can figure out how to properly. How do I do that? Let's do that. No, he left! Ballin'. Thank you! Some Dark Souls shit right there. Now let's do some fishing. I don't know why I'm trying to walk around when I can just do it right here. Sick. Fished 100 items. Alright, so that means this is my 10th time fishing. What do I actually do with the fish? You see that? A fresh ocean sun. What do I do with those? Is that just like a collectible? Can I sell them somewhere? Thank you for the May colors, you assholes. You better back that ass up, boy. I'll fucking smack you in the face with my fishing rod. Demon King! I can dig that. This will be the last one, I promise. I like how there's one person in ranked match searching right now in this entire lobby. There's one person. Dirt cheap Spanish mackerel. Excellent. That's the kind of fish you want to catch. Sweet battle music. I like getting music. Okay. I hope you enjoyed. And, oh, okay, there is more than one person. Hope you enjoyed that wonderful match you just got to witness of my amazing Jacko. Like I said, I still got a lot to learn. I got a lot of progress that I need to make. So anyway, thank you for watching. Peace out.